Hello everyone, my name is Vivi Chauhan. I'm assistant professor in Gyan Vihar School of Pharmacy, which is a part of Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. So today we are going to discuss about this alcohol topic, alcohol, which comes in your pharmaceutical organic chemistry first. And in this, we are going to study about this alcohol. And here, the learning objective of this topic is we were going to study about what are the alcohols, which we have also discussed in the last two lectures also. What are the alcohol, what are its type of alcohol, and that is your primary, secondary, and your tertiary alcohols, and what are the basicity, acidity of this alcohol, and also about the method of preparation of this alcohol, and the chemical methods of this alcohol. In the method of preparation of alcohol, we have studied about how the alcohol are produced on the prepared on the industrial scale or in the lab laboratory scale, and how this alcohol is reacting with the other reagents in the presence of the catalyst and giving us the different products. So here we are going to discuss about the qualitative test for your alcohol, and also we are going to study about the structures and uses of organic compounds that are related with this alcohol. So the student outcome. So the student will going to learn about the alcohols, their identification tests for the alcohol. So how we can identify the alcohol if we have given an unknown sample in the labs. In the practicals also we get an unknown sample in the laboratories, and the teachers said that you have to find out the unknown sample is it. So we do tests on that sample and identify that it is a carboxylic acid or it is an aldehyde, ketone, alcohol, which type of organic compound it is. And here we are also going to study about the structures and uses of organic compounds which are related to this alcohols, which are the derivative of the alcohol, you can say, or these are the alcohols, and that contains ethyl alcohol, methyl alcohols. These are some of the examples of this alcohols. So these are the learning objective of this topic, and the students will going to know about this topic. Next is your the qualitative test. Before the qualitative test, we should also just summarize that what are the alcohols. So alcohols are the organic compounds that are having the hydroxyl group attached to the organic chain, attached to your aliphatic chain or your unsaturated chain. That is your alkene or your alkyne. So here the alkenes or your alkene. So here the alcohols are the organic compounds which are having the OH group, function group, that is attached to the organic compound, and they are of the three types. First your primary, second your secondary, and third is your tertiary. So the primary alcohols are the alcohols that is having, that is bonded to one alkyl group. And on the one side, it is bonded to the hydroxyl group, and the two hydrogen atoms are bonded to it. So that is your primary alcohol. So in case of secondary alcohol, the secondary alcohol is having the two alkyl group, and on one side, there is a hydroxyl group bonded to it, and when hydrogen is bonded to it. So this is your secondary alcohol. And in the case of your tertiary alcohol, there is no hydrogen atoms are bonded to this tertiary alcohol, and only the three alkyl groups are attached to your carbon atom. So and three alkyl groups are attached, and on one side the hydroxyl group is attached to it. These are the three alkyl, alcohols that are these type of three type of alcohols that are the type of this alcohol. So alcohol generally is having the OH function group attached to it. So the qualitative test through which the we can identify that that this unknown sample is your alcohol. So these are the qualitative tests. The first qualitative test is your chromic acid oxidation. So in this test, distinguish between the primary and your secondary alcohol from your tertiary. So this alcohol test, in your alcohol test, from your alcohol, there are three types of primary, secondary, and your tertiary alcohol. So here, this chromic acid oxidation test is going to distinguish between which is your primary alcohol, which is your secondary alcohol, and which your tertiary. From this tertiary, this primary and secondary are distinguished. So this is your chromic acid oxidation. So in your chromic acid oxidation, the chromic acid will oxidize our primary alcohol first to an aldehyde and to a carboxylic acid, and it will oxidize the secondary alcohol to a ketone. So here, due to this chromic acid, due to the presence of this chromic acid, the primary alcohol will firstly oxidize into the aldehyde. First, it will convert into the aldehyde, and then this aldehyde will convert into the carboxylic acid. So this is the primary alcohol that gives this chromic acid oxidation test. So in this, the primary alcohol is oxidizes first to the aldehyde. It will first convert it into the aldehyde and then to a carboxylic acid. Now in the case of secondary alcohol, secondary alcohol will oxidize into the ketone. Convert it into the ketone, or you can say it will oxidize in the presence of this chromic acid, and there is a formation of this ketone. So in the both, you will see that there are presence of this hydrogen. But in case of your tertiary alcohol do not react, do not give this test, because tertiary alcohol, the OH bearing carbon must have a hydrogen atom attached. So the carbon which is attached to the OH functional group should have one or two hydrogen present with it, then only it will give this chromic acid oxidation test. Otherwise, it will not give this chromic acid oxidation test. Similarly, in case of your tertiary alcohol, do not react, because there is no presence of this. Hydrogen atom that is attached to the carbon, which is already attached to the OH bond. That is why it is not giving any chromic acid oxidation test. So this chromic acid oxidation, as the name signifies, that the oxidation which is happening due to this chromic acid in the alcohol, in your primary, secondary, or your tertiary, in your primary and secondary alcohol, this gives your qualitative or your identification of your alcohol. So here, this test is also going to distinguish this primary and secondary alcohols from this tertiary, because the tertiary do not contain any hydrogen atom with it, because it is having three alkyl groups that is attached to the carbon, which is bonded to the OH function group. So here, the primary and secondary alcohols is giving this test because they are attached to the two hydrogen atom. That is why this primary and secondary alcohol are giving this chromic acid oxidation test. Next is your chromic acid will oxidize this primary alcohol. Firstly, the primary alcohol is oxidizes in the to your aldehyde. After that, it is oxidizes to your carboxylic acid. And this we have seen in the chemical reaction of alcohol also. You can see the chemical reaction of alcohol. The first reaction that we have done, the oxidation, there you can see that the primary alcohol is first oxidizes in the presence of the oxidants, and oxidants in your first aldehyde, and then it will oxidize into your carboxylic acid, and the secondary alcohol will oxidize into your ketone, and it will not further oxidize into the carboxylic acid. Only the aldehyde will oxidize in your carboxylic acid, but not the ketone. Ketone will not convert, or you can say the not a distinguish no sorry not not oxidizes to this carboxylic acid. So the primary gives the carboxylic acid, the final product after oxidation, and secondary gives the ketone after oxidation with this chromic acid. Next is your Ritter test. So your Ritter test, in your Ritter test, this test is similar to the chromic acid oxidation, and this in this also the oxidation of primary and secondary alcohol to carboxylic acid and ketone using potassium permanganate. Again, tertiary alcohol cannot be oxidized by this reagent because there is no hydrogen to be lost from the carbon then bearing the OH group. So Ritter test is also similar to that of your chromic acid oxidation test, because in this test is also happening, there is also oxidation is happening in the presence of your KMnO4, which is your potassium permanganate. So here again the oxidation of primary and secondary alcohol give the carboxylic acid and your ketone in the presence of your potassium permanganate, and here you will see that there is a change in color. Means here the potassium permanganate is your purple color, and when it is oxidizes the primary alcohol, then it will give a brown color. And both of them, because the MnO2 is formed, which is oxidizes, and there is a formation of this brown color. You can check from this color that this alcohol is formed. So primary and alcohol will give this test, Ritter test. Again, the tertiary alcohol will not give this test because there is no hydrogen atom that is to be lost from the carbon that is bonded to your OH, already bonded to the OH group. It is bonded to the alkyl groups. That is why it does not give the test. So here the tertiary alcohol will not give this test. So there is no hydrogen to be lost from the carbon that bears the hydroxy group. And the oxidation of primary and secondary alcohol to carboxylic acid and ketone using potassium permanganate. So here you can see the primary alcohol of potassium permanganate. When this primary alcohol will react with this potassium permanganate is having the KMnO4, and this will convert into the MnO2. That is why the purple color is changed into the brown. So here the primary alcohol, when reacting with this, or you can say when it is oxidizing in the presence of your potassium permanganate, and this primary alcohol is converted, or there is a formation of this carboxylic acid as well as this brown color. Secondly, the secondary alcohol, when this reacting or oxidizes in the presence of this potassium permanganate, which is of purple color, then it is converted to this ketone and there is a formation of this MnO2 that is of brown color. So this is your Ritter test. This is your Ritter test, and that is your chromic acid oxidation. In a chromic acid oxidation, we have used our chromic acid and H2CR2O7. And here in the Ritter test, we are using here potassium permanganate. That is your oxidant. That is used as an oxidant, and it oxidizes your alcohol to your acid as well as your ketone. Firstly, the primary alcohol is oxidizes to your aldehyde, and then it is oxidizes to the carboxylic acid. But in the case of secondary alcohol, it only oxidizes in the ketone, but not in the carboxylic acid. And the tertiary alcohol do not give this test, or you can say the tertiary alcohol cannot be oxidized by this reagent, by this KMnO4 reagent, because there is no hydrogen present or to be lost from the carbon that is already bearing this OH group and also bearing the alkyl group. So these are the two tests of this qualitative identification test of your alcohol. Next is your Lucas test. So in your Lucas test, this test distinguishes tertiary, secondary, and primary alcohol from here. The two above tests, the chromic acid and the Ritter test, they are distinguishing the primary and secondary from your tertiary. But this in this Lucas test, this test is distinguishing the tertiary, secondary, and your primary alcohol from each other. So here we are going to use this zinc chloride as a reagent in presence of this concentrated HCl. So this is your Lucas reagent. So this Lucas test is important. So in this, you can easily distinguish your tertiary, primary, and secondary. And here the reagent that is used for this distinguishing is your Lucas reagent, which is your zinc chloride with your concentrated HCl. So this zinc chloride reagent in your concentrated HCl is acting as your Lucas reagent and is based on the rate of formation of insoluble alkyl chloride. So this test is based on the formation, or you can say based on the rate of formation of your insoluble alkyl chloride, and an emulsion is formed here. So here this Lucas test. So here in the Lucas test, there is a reagent that is your zinc chloride as well as your concentrated HCl. So this test is used to distinguish your tertiary alcohol from your secondary alcohol and from your primary alcohol. And in this test, there is a formation of your insoluble alkyl chloride. So it is based on the rate of formation of your insoluble alkyl chloride. And here an emulsion is formed, which will distinguishes your tertiary, secondary, and your primary alcohol from each other. So here in your tertiary alcohol, when this tertiary alcohol will react with this Lucas reagent, then it will immediately form an emulsion of your alkyl halide and a water molecule, water. This tertiary alcohol will react immediately to form an emulsion of the alkyl halide in water. There is a formation of this cloudy solution. So it signifies, it shows that this is your tertiary alcohol. This shows the presence of your tertiary alcohol, because the tertiary alcohol will react with this zinc chloride and in concentrated HCl, and there is a formation of this alkyl chloride. Yes, the alkyl chloride, or you can say the alkyl halide and water. And you will see appearance of the cloudy solution when this reaction will complete. And the secondary alcohol, in your secondary alcohol, it will react in 5 to 10 minutes. This secondary alcohol will react with this Lucas reagent to 5 to 10 minutes. And heating in warm water and shaking is sometimes necessary with water insoluble alcohol. So here the secondary alcohol, it will take 5 to 10 minutes, or it will take some minutes to dissolve or to form an emulsion. And if necessary, we have to heat this in your warm water and shake it sometimes, because it is necessary with the alcohols that are not soluble, or you can say that are insoluble in your water. So this secondary alcohol react in 5 to 10 minutes heating in warm water and shaking it sometime necessary. You have to shake it also so that the water will mix with this insoluble alcohol. Now in case of primary alcohol, these generally take more than 1 hour to react. So this primary alcohol as either sometimes not give any reaction, or if they give reaction, then it will take more than 1 hour to react. So in the last two tests, in the chromic acid oxidation and in your Ritter test, we have seen that it is shown that the tertiary alcohol is not giving both the tests. But in this Lucas test, this primary alcohol is not, or you can say it will take more than 1 hour to react with this Lucas reagent, or it will take more time to react with this Lucas reagent. So here, this Lucas test is used in the labs so that we can distinguish between the samples of your tertiary from your secondary and from your primary alcohols from each other. And in this, we use our Lucas reagent, which is your zinc chloride with your concentrated HCl. And here the product which is formed is your based on the rate of formation of the insoluble alkyl chlorides, and it is in the form of your emulsion form. The product that is formed is in the form of your emulsion form. So here the first is your tertiary alcohol. We have taken the tertiary alcohol. The tertiary alcohol will react immediately with this Lucas reagent, and there is a formation of this emulsion is formed. This because of the formation of this alkyl halide in water, cloudy solution is formed. Secondly, in your secondary alcohol, it reacts in 5 to 10 minutes. It reacts in 5 to 10 minutes, and sometimes it is heating is required in case of this secondary alcohol, and shaking is sometimes necessary with water, insoluble alcohol. And the primary alcohols sometimes do not react with this Lucas reagent, or if it reacts with this Lucas reagent, then it will take more than 1 hour to react. Next is the reactions. These are the reactions that is showing that there is what will be the product formed in the emulsion or in the insoluble alkyl halide. So here you can see the first is your primary alcohol, which is your ethyl alcohol, and in the process, in the reactant, in the reaction with this zinc chloride and HCl, there is a formation, there is no reaction formed with this primary alcohol with this Lucas reagent. So here there will be no reaction formed, or you can say the primary alcohol do not react with this Lucas reagent. Now secondly is your secondary butyl alcohol. So in your secondary butyl alcohol, then the secondary butyl alcohol is reacting with this zinc chloride plus HCl, then there is a formation of this secondary butyl chloride, because here the chloride halogen is present. So here the secondary butyl chloride, you can see here this OH is replaced from here, and from here this Cl will react with this Cl. So here this OH will be removed, or you can say is replaced by this chlorine. So here the secondary butyl alcohol, from the secondary butyl alcohol, this secondary butyl chloride is formed, which is your alkyl chloride, or you can say the alkyl halide. So the insoluble alkyl halide is formed in case of this. Okay, next is your tertiary butyl alcohol. So in your tertiary butyl alcohol, you can see here the tertiary butyl alcohol is with this OH, and there you will see this zinc chloride will react with this, and it immediately will react with this tertiary butyl alcohol. This zinc chloride will immediately react with this tertiary butyl alcohol, and there is a formation of this tertiary butyl chloride. Tertiary butyl chloride is formed when this zinc chloride is reacted with this tertiary butyl alcohol. So here you will see this OH is your alcohol, and here you can see that in tertiary butyl alcohol, all the three are your alkyl group, but in case of this primary, only one alkyl group is there. And this OH is connected, and those two hydrogens are there. That is why it is not giving any reaction. And in this case, it is giving the reaction. This secondary butyl alcohol and this tertiary butyl alcohol is giving a reaction. Next is your Lucas reagent. So here, this like this tertiary alcohol, you can see here this secondary alcohol, the tertiary alcohol will also react like this. So here you will see the tertiary alcohol react in 3 to 10 minutes. How? So here you will see this oxygen is having the electrons, and here this zinc will react with this oxygen, and there is a formation of this OH, ZnCl. So here you will see HCl and H2O. So here you will see this will remove, with this will take, this will hold, this ZnCl OH will hold, will withdraw from here, and there will be a positive charge on this carbon atom, because this oxygen has withdrawn electron from this carbon atom. So this carbon is having the positive charge. So there is a formation of this secondary butyl alcohol. So it is having this, not alcohol, this is a secondary butyl. So secondary butyl is much more stable than your primary. That is why here you can see the this whole process is happening due to the carbocation stability. So here this is secondary alcohol is more stable than your primary alcohol, and there this chlorine will react with this this chlorine which is left from this zinc chloride. So this will react with this carbon, and there is a formation of the secondary alkyl chloride, which is also not soluble, but it reacts in 3 to 10 minutes, or you can say it needed a warmed environment. So means it is heated in the warm water. Secondly, the primary alcohol. Primary alcohol requires more than one more than an hour to react. If it react all, firstly, if it reacts, then it required more than 1 hour, and if it does, secondly, it do not react. So here you can see the primary alcohol, which is your water soluble, and when it react with this Lucas reagent, that is your zinc chloride, HCl and H2O, there is no reaction in several hours possible. So here you will see, because of this primary alcohol is not stable carbocation, it is not stable carbocation, that is why the rate of reaction is not happening here. So in case of your tertiary alcohol, the same reaction will help. But in this case, but in case of tertiary alcohol, this H is replaced by the alkyl group. That is why the reaction process is fast. And there is a formation of this alkyl chloride, and it will readily react with this. And if there is a formation of this, there is a formation of the alkyl chloride. So this is your Lucas reagent, Lucas test. So there are the three tests that is this alcohol is giving. First is your chromic acid oxidation test. Second is your Ritter test. Third is your Lucas test. So in your chromic acid oxidation test, what we have studied that in that test, there is an oxidation is happening in the presence of your chromic acid. And the primary alcohol is oxidizes in the presence of your chromic acid, and it is giving you, firstly, it is giving the aldehyde. After that, it oxidizes again, and that is giving you carboxylic acid. But in case of primary alcohol, in case of secondary alcohol, it does not, it gives you ketone, not aldehyde. And this ketone is not oxidizes to carboxylic acid. Firstly, it oxidizes, secondary alcohol oxidizes to this oxidizes in the presence of this chromic acid to this ketone. but it does not further or oxidizes to your carboxylic acid. Only the primary alcohol oxidizes in your carboxylic acid. So here, and thirdly, the tertiary alcohol do not react or do not form gives the oxidation with this chromic acid test. So the tertiary do not give the chromic acid oxidation test. That is why we can distinguish the primary and secondary from this tertiary alcohol. Secondly, in your Ritter test, which is also similar to the chromic acid test, in this also the primary alcohol oxidizes in the presence of the potassium permanganate, and the potassium permanganate is having the purple color, and it get oxidizes to your carboxylic acid. Firstly, it will oxidize into aldehyde, as after that it will oxidize into carboxylic acid. Then it is giving the brown color, which shows that there is a presence of this alcohol, and the alcohol is oxidizing in the presence of your potassium permanganate. Secondly, the secondary alcohol will also oxidizes in the presence of your potassium permanganate, and it will give you ketone. And here, it will also show the brown color, because the potassium permanganate is oxidizes to your MnO2. It is having the KMn4, MnO4. Here it will oxidizes to your MnO2. So here you will see that the both primary and secondary will give the brown color, but they are not. But in case of tertiary alcohol, it is not oxidizes. Third is your Lucas test. In your Lucas test, this test will distinguish between your tertiary, primary, and your secondary. So here all the three alcohols are going to distinguish from each other. So here we required a Lucas reagent. So the Lucas reagent is your zinc chloride in your HCl. So here the Lucas reagent is your zinc chloride with your HCl. So concentrated in your concentrated HCl. So here the tertiary alcohol, which is your tertiary alcohol, it will give the test immediately, and there is a formation of this alkyl chloride, insoluble alkyl chloride, and there is a formation of the emulsion in the case of your tertiary alcohol. But in case of your secondary alcohol, this reaction will take some time, or you can say it will take 3 to 10 minutes. In reacting with this Lucas reagent, the secondary alcohol. And here, if it does not react in this time, then we have to heat in the warm water. After that, this will give you our alkyl chloride. Thirdly, the primary alcohol. Primary alcohol requires more than R if it reacts with this Lucas reagent. But if does not react, then if do not react, then it will give you no reaction. So in this primary alcohol case, it will give no reaction in several hours. And this whole Lucas test is happening due to the this carbocation stability. Because in tertiary alcohol, the tertiary carbocation is more stable than your secondary and your primary. And the secondary alcohol. In your secondary alcohol, which is the carbocation in this formed, is stable than your primary alcohol. So in primary alcohol, there is no carbocation stability. That is why the rate of reaction is related to this carbocation stability. And it is written that the tertiary is much more stable than the secondary, and the secondary is much more stable than your primary alcohol. Next, these are the structures and uses of some of the organic compounds that are related to this alcohol. And the first is your ethyl alcohol. And ethyl alcohol is also known as your ethanol, or you can say alcohol, or your drinking alcohol. So the structure of this ethyl alcohol is your base. It is known as ethanol because there is a presence of the two carbon atoms. So these are the two carbon atoms which are present in your ethanol. That is why we have used ethane and E is replaced by your OH. So E is replaced by your OH. So that is why it is known as your ethanol. And this ethanol is your alcohol, and it is also known as your drinking alcohol. So the uses of ethanol. So what are its uses in the ethanol, that is your alcohol, and the uses of ethanol is your it is used in alcoholic beverages. So it is used in your alcohol beverages, means the thing which we are drinking, the alcohol that is present in it. So in that beverages, we are there is a presence of this ethanol, and it is also used as a solvent. It is also used as a solvent. It is also used as a scent. It is also used as a flavoring agent, coloring in medicines, also in chemical synthesis, also, and in your thermometer also. In your thermometer, there is a presence of this ethanol also. As we all know, there is a presence of mercury, but in some cases, in some thermometers, there is a presence of now ethanol also. So ethanol is used in your beverages, alcoholic beverages, in your solvents. As a solvent, it is used. In your scents, it is used as a flavoring agent. It is used as a coloring agent. It is used. And in case of medicines also, it is used. And in the chemical synthesis, it is also required, this ethanol. And in thermometer also, it is used, this ethanol. Next is your ethanol is used as a fuel, an excellent solvent, and an important raw material for making other chemicals. So this ethanol is used as a fuel. It is also used as a fuel, an excellent solvent. It is also used as a solvent, an important raw material for making other chemicals. So this ethanol is used as a raw material for making other chemical also, and it is also used as a fuel and an excellent solvent also for dissolving the other chemical, and it is also used as a raw material for making other chemicals. So pure ethanol is toxic liquid. So this is pure ethanol is toxic liquid, and methanol, which is even more toxic, is sometimes added to it to put off anyone wanting to drink it. So here, pure ethanol is toxic liquid. It is a toxic liquid. And this methanol is also even more toxic to compared to this pure ethanol. And it is added to this, this methanol is added to this ethanol so that someone does not drink it. This ethanol, this pure ethanol, because ethanol is a toxic, or you can say carcinogenic also. So this is your ethyl alcohol, which is also known as your ethanol, because it is also known as ethanol because it is having the two ethane molecule, and alcohol is attached. So we have to use the suffix ol here. So ethanol, E is replaced by this ol. So this is your ethanol. Secondly, ethyl alcohol, because this is your ethyl alcohol and this is your alcohol. This OH is attached, this is your alcohol, and it is also known as your alcohol. This ethyl alcohol is also known as your alcohol, and this is also known as your drinking alcohol, that you can drink this alcohol also. So this is the structure of this ethyl alcohol, and what are the uses? It is used as in your alcoholic beverages, and in as a solvent, in your solvent it is used, in your scent it is used, as a flavoring agent it is used, as a coloring medicine. Coloring agent it is used, in your medicines also it is used, as a chemical synthesis also used, thermometer also used, ethanol is used as a fuel, an excellent solvent, and an important raw material in making other chemicals, and it is very toxic, and methanol is more even more toxic to this pure ethanol, and it is put off anyone wanting to drink it. Next is a mixture of ethanol and methanol is also known as your methylated spirit, or sometimes meths used in camping stoves. So when somebody goes to the camping, then in the camping stoves also this ethanol and methanol mixture is used, and this is also known as your methylated spirit or meths also. So used as a raw material for making esters, which is in turn used as solvent in food flavoring and in manufacture of cosmetics also. So this ethanol as a raw material is used as for making this esters, which is used in the which is used as a solvent in food flavoring. This ester is used as a food flavoring as a solvent and is also used in the manufacture of your cosmetics. So this alcohol is also used in the manufacture of your cosmetics also. So vinegar, a weak solution of ethanoic acid, is produced by ethanol by a biochemical process. So this vinegar, which is a weak carboxylic acid, or you can say a weak ethanoic acid, a weak solution of ethanoic, is prepared or is produced from this by the biochemical process. From this biochemical process, this vinegar is prepared from this ethanol and which is a weak ethanoic acid. And it also involves, this vinegar also involves the oxidation caused by bacteria called acetobacter. So here, the bacteria which is oxidizing or which is involving in this reaction from ethanol to your vinegar. A bacteria is causing this oxidation, which is also known as your acetobacter. So this acetobacter bacteria is oxidizing this ethanol into your vinegar, which is your carboxylic, or you can say a weak solution of your ethanoic acid. And it is happening by the biochemical process. Next is your methanol. So methanol, it is acquired the name wood alcohol because it was once produced as a byproduct of the destructive distillation of wood. So this is also known as your wood alcohol. This is your wood alcohol, and it is produced as a byproduct, and it is produced as a byproduct of the destructive distillation of your wood. When we have done the destructive distillation of wood, this methanol is produced by it as a wood byproduct, and it is also a wood alcohol. It is also named as a wood alcohol. And today, industrial methanol, industrially, this methanol is prepared by this or produced by the catalytic process directly from this carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide and your hydrogen. Then the methanol is formed. This is your methanol because one carbon atom is attached to methane and E is replaced by your alcohol suffix ol. So that is why it is known as your methanol. You can say methyl alcohol also. The uses of methanol. So it is used in your polymers after getting converted to your formaldehyde. So it is used in the formation of your polymer after it is getting converted to your formaldehyde. So it is converted to your formaldehyde. It is used in the production of your polymer and polymers that is your converted to your formaldehyde. And it is also used to produce the hydrocarbons also. And it is also used as a precursor for many methyl esters, methyl amines and your methyl halides. So here methanol is named after a wood alcohol because it is obtained from the destructive distillation of your wood. And here industrially it is produced from the carbon monoxide catalytic process directly from the carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide and the hydrogen. And the uses of methanol, that it is used to produce the hydrocarbon. It is also used as a precursor for methyl esters, methyl amines and your methyl halides. It is also used as a fuel for internal combustion engines. So in engines, it is used as a fuel for internal combustion. It is an excellent energy carrier, and it is also used in wastewater plant. It is used in your wastewater plant, and it is used in your fuel in your boating stoves and your camping. In your camping also, camping stoves also, and your boating stove also, it is used as a fuel. And it is used as an antifreeze also. It is used as an antifreeze. It is used in the synthesis of chemicals. And pure methanol is used in the manufacture of your perfume, resins, and pharmaceuticals. Next is your chlorobutanol. So here, chlorobutanol is your trichloro-2-methyl-2-propanol. As you can see the structure of this chlorobutanol, you can see the three chlorine atoms are attached to this carbon. And it is your three carbon propanol because 1, 2, and 3. So here you can see its name is trichloro. From here we are starting the numbering 1, 2, 3. So here on the second, the hydroxy group is also present and one methyl group is also present. So here to trichloro 2-methyl propanol. So its name is 2 and it is also known as chlorobutanol. So here it is a chemical preservative, sedative, hypnotic and weak local anesthetic. It is an antibacterial and antifungal property. This chlorobutanol is having a antibacterial and antifungal property, and it is also used as a chemical preservative, sedative and hypnotic, and your weak anesthetic. It is also used as a weak anesthetic also. Next, its uses of chlorobutanol is that it is used in as an antibacterial mouthwashes. It is used in mouthwashes also as an antibacterial. Gingivitis, it is used in gingivitis. It means inflammation in the gums. So it is used there also. And oral hygiene following oral surgeries and oral ulceration. Means in your mouth, there is a ulceration. So it is used in ulceration, oral ulceration also. Oral candidal infection also and minor throat infection also. So here, these are the use of this chlorobutanol, which is used in the antibacterial mouthwashes, gingivitis, oral hygiene following oral heart surgeries, oral ulceration, oral candidal infection and minor throat infection, and your denature cleaning of your mouth. Next is your cetosterile alcohol. So this is the structure of your cetosterile alcohol, and it is a mixture of your fatty alcohol consisting of cetyl and sterile alcohol, and it is also classified as fatty alcohol. So here this is the structure of your cetosterile alcohol, and it is used in helping to preventing creams from separating oil and liquid, and this chemical that helps to keep liquid and oil together is known as emulsifier. So it is used as emulsifier also. It may also make a product thicker or increase the product stability to form. Next product with cetosterile alcohol are, these are used in skin lotion, moisturizer, skin creams, sun creams, shampoo, conditioner, hair removal cream, hair mousse, anti-frizz hair cream, hair dye and mascaras also. So next is your benzyl alcohol. So this is the structure of your benzyl alcohol. C6H5CH2. This is your CH2 and OH. And the IUPAC name is your phenyl methanol. At room temperature, this benzyl alcohol is a colorless liquid, and it is having this aromatic smell. So uses of it, it is used as a solvent in your epoxy resin coating, ink and paints. And it is also solution of this benzyl alcohol is used with a concentration of 10%, can be used as a local anesthetic and also as an antimicrobial agent. And it is also used in a component of the fluid mixture in electronic cigarettes also, which enhances its flavor. And it is also used as a dielectric solvent for the reconfiguration of the nanowires via dielectrophoresis. Next is your glycerol. So this benzyl alcohol, 5% of its compound can be used to treat your head lice, and it is used in the manufacture of soaps, shampoos and skin lotions because it is having the antifungal and antibacterial property. Next is your glycerin. So glycerin is a simple poly compound, and its chemical formula is the C3H8O3, and it is also known as glycerol or glycerin. And it is hygroscopic in nature, and it is found in lipid and obtained from animal or plant sources. And it is a water soluble due to the 3-hydroxy group present. So the uses of this glycerol is that it is used in the beverages and food industry. It is also used as a humectant, sweetener and a solvent. It is also used as a preservative for the storage of food items. And it is also used in food industry as a sweetener and preservative. And it is also used as a liquener, as a thickening agent. It is not uncommon for glycerin to be a filler in low-fat food items such as cookies. And it is also used as a glycerin in medical and pharmaceutical industry as a lubricant and humectant. And this glycerin is also used in the treatment of several eye pressures, increased eye pressure. And it is also used in moisturizing properties because it prevents the dry skin. And it's used in pharmaceutical industry for the preparation of cough syrup also. Next, glycerin is a vital component of many skin products. That is your production of toothpaste also. It is also used in the production of your cigarette also, liquid cigarette, electronic liquid cigarette. It is also used in explosives such as dynamite. It is also used to damp the vibration and pressure cause. And it is used in film industry also. And it is used in the moisture solvent and sweetener in food and beverages. It is also used in your liquor as a kidney agent, and it also have approximately 27 kilocalories per teaspoon as a sugar substitute. And it is also used in does not nourish the plaque forming bacteria that produces dactyl cavity. Next is your propylene glycol. So this is a synthetic liquid that is produced variety of purposes in pharmaceutical, cosmetic, food and manufacturing industry. And this is the structure of your propylene glycol. It is used in variety of products, manufacturing process, and it is also used in solvent and drug manufacturing. It is also used to dissolve other substances without changing their fundamental structures and composition. It is used in cosmetic industries. And this cosmetic propylene glycol is also commonly found ingredient in cosmetics and personal skincare, humectant, and propylene glycol worked as a humectant by attracting moisture to the skin. It is also used as solvent, emollient, and the viscosity controller. Next, it is also used as a preservative. It is also used in food industry in anti-caking agent, solvent in food flavoring, dose strengthener and a flavor in food, and as a preservative in antimicrobial, because it is having antimicrobial properties. It is also used as a food thickener and also retain moisture in food. Now the question, what is a Lucas reagent? So the Lucas reagent is your zinc chloride and concentrated HCl. That is your answer A. Next, your gingivitis and oral ulceration can be treated by your chlorobutanol. This is your chlorobutanol, option B. Next is your, which act as emulsifier, that is your stearosterol alcohol. IUPAC name of benzyl alcohol is your phenyl methanol. Next, which is used as sugar substitute, that is your glycerol. Next is your gingivitis oral ulceration can be treated by your chlorobutanol. In dehydration of alcohol is an example of your the elimination reaction, and IUPAC name of benzyl alcohol is phenyl methanol. Next is your, the name of this compound is CCl4, which is your carbon tetrachloride, or you can say the tetrachloromethane. Next is your, in which it is used as a disinfectant. So this is your iodoform is used as a disinfectant. So these are the references where you can study this topic. And thank you so much.